stakes are higher.
I wanted to shoot this one more practically than it's ever been done before.
The things that happen in this film are just like, okay, wait a minute. Nobody's ever seen that before, ever.
Once again, we have 100% reinvented ourselves, and that's what we seem to do every time.
What the Fast fans realized is that we were willing to defy expectations with every single chapter. And even with that, just when you think you know, you have no idea.
Well, that was new.
When you come up, you look, just commit to it all the way.
I knew Justin was going to be bad to a direct Fast 9 because he is in the Fast family for life.
I was inspired to come back by the fact that there's a mythology that we were exploring that still had not been told.
Justin, dude, there's nothing better than a veteran director who loves the franchise to come in and give it the right attention.
Yeah. When it comes to every detail of every frame, that is Justin Lin, 100%.
I just love me some Justin Lin. He's the heartbeat of this franchise. No one knows these characters. No one knows the world better than Justin Lin.
I understand his passion. Justin is attached to narrative. He refuses to do action for the sake of action.
He has crafted a tale that audiences are going to be so excited to show up for, and I think he was the only one who could do it.
I'm really proud that my part 9 were able to bring something fresh for the viewers.
All right, Dom. What's next?
We're taking Dom, Letty, Mina, all these characters to places emotionally that no one's ever seen before.
We heard y'all needed a little love out here.
The idea that this character that was an outlaw is now a father is a very interesting subject to explore in this next chapter.
The underlying theme of all of these movies and what people resonate with so much is the theme of love. And then taking it a step further and what it means to be a father.
Being stronger, sitting's exceptional.
Once you're a father, you're not just living or dying for yourself. You have someone else to take care of, so that just raises the stakes big time.
In order for Dom to be a father in the truest sense, he has to go and revisit his past.
Who is he?
Jacob is Dom's brother.
It's been a long time, Dom. Little brother. You keep digging around in the past, you're gonna let you find it.
At some point, we all have to deal with our past in order to define our future. And so this idea opened up a great opportunity for us to explore family in the traditional sense, the bloodlines.
This is a huge development in the overall structure because Dom has always defined his family as those he holds closest, not necessarily those who share his last name.
Now your little family is in my world.
This particular Toretto has the same skill sets, power, strength, and confidence, if not more, than our beloved Dom.
I said to John to play a Toretto, you're gonna have to be prepared to go to some dark places. And I believed him when he said, whatever it takes.
Jacob is like Dom's alter ego. He is stealth. He is quiet. He is never seen. He just gets the job done. He always seems to have the chessboard set 3 moves ahead. In typical Toretto fashion.
I've spent my entire life in your shadow. Now, you're gonna spend the rest of yours living in mine.
Just seeing him and Van on set for the first day of filming, eye to eye, was crazy. And kind of made me want to step in. Hey, break it up, you know.
The idea of Han coming back,
no way.
I have to say, was done in conjunction with the fans. You know, people care. And that's how the whole movement of Justice for Han came about. this is truly like the people's movie. They, in a way, demanded for this character to come back. Thus, I'm sitting here again.
He brings such a great element of his culture to this franchise, and he's just a great person all around.
We're connected to the hit forever because of this franchise, and it was like coming to a family reunion.
It's good to be back.
Your whole life, you pushed yourself to be faster than Don, smarter than Don, stronger than Don. Do you hate him enough that it keeps you up at night? Still, all these years later.
To be able to work with Charlize and bring Cypher back, it was a lot of fun to work together on set. In a way, she's operating on a different level.
Could you kill him? Because I'm ready if you are.
Charlize is not as good as you all think she is. She's far better than that. I was looking at her in amazement at how good she is.
I bet all you ever wanted was a hug.
You read my SAGA email. Good for you.
Cypher is a credible threat. She's scary. She's intelligent. She's cunning and brilliant. It's such an incredible gift for us to be able to have Charlize in that role.
Guess who's out of the box, Jamaica?
You were never my competition.
Nice necklace, Queenie. Diamonds and emeralds never look so good.
Aside from the fact that I just love Helen Mirren, and I love working with her, she brings such a regal element to the franchise.
We have a go. Let's have a back.
You coming? I love the juxtapositioning of the themes in Fast and Furious with this wonderful mad ride that the audience go on, but it's always underpinned with real emotion, with stories of family.
Well, I'm not the only one with a family full of eccentrics.
She always had the wish to drive because she's a very good driver, by the way.
Did you bring for me, would you drive?
They've given me an amazing sequence and an incredible car to drive. It's called a Noble. It's a British-made car, so I'm thrilled with that. It's a wonderful piece of machinery. You just feel you're glued to the road.
To be able to have a Queenie chase that curve around Buckingham Palace and see it that close, it was a dream, and I can't believe that we were able to achieve that.
So much for granny shifting.
Okay, this is a bad time to mention this, but I don't drive. Reap is on the left, so he's right.
Ramsey gets to drive! Yay! And not, you know, just tap away at a computer. She's never driven a car before, but has to drive this big truck thing. She doesn't drive well, but she is victorious in her mission. She gets the truck where it needs to go, and in my opinion, that's the main thing.
Hey, that was not my fault!
Maddie, come here! Now!
The thing I love about this journey is I get a lot of action, which was so fun and so invigorating. I can't be in a Fast and Furious movie and not do that stuff. That's just not fair.
It's just refreshing to have her be part of the action.
Her dad always wants a challenge, so when I told her I was going to really push her, she was all in.
The stunt team has been amazing, and they taught it to me like a dance. It was weeks and weeks of prep. I just think it's really cool. Whereas Michelle can just pick it up like that.
I did get some hands-on with the fight. In some crazy, sadistic way, I really enjoyed it.
If you're looking at just the action itself here in F9, the logistics size is unparalleled. The idea to go more practical with our action sequences and to feel like a thing's captured with the camera, even in the craziest of situations, it really did affect the way we define our look, our aesthetic, and how it was designed.
Careful when you get hurt!
One of the things that stands out with working with Justin, there has to be a reason for all the action, because Fast is about streets, it's about spirit of the moment and what you're going to do with that instinct that these guys have and have to create right there on the spot. So the challenge challenges to keep it real, doing things from practical, from organicness, and the audience gets blown away by it, literally.
Cut. Oh, that was great. We didn't want to compromise. We really wanted to push each other.
Shoot it again right away.
Justin, when he started telling me some of the ideas, I was like, okay, all right. We got our work cut out for us.
This is an amazing group of people. I mean, they're at the top of their profession. I give the crew all the credit for making it happen.
Tell them I can't get to you.
Crank it all the way up.
That's another level.
Yes!
Just another day on Fast 9.
Whatever's on you, it's on us. Let's get to work. There were these magical moments that happened on set. You could feel it. The whole crew felt this magic.
It means a lot to be able to go on these journeys with people that I trust and to be able to really be there for each other.
I got you. It's like soldiers in the field, you know? I just find it such a beautiful metaphor for loyalty.
These guys are just uberly talented, man. Just, like, where do y'all come up with this stuff?
The fact that we are a Fast family and our crew continue to raise the bar each and every time really resonates on and off screen.
Fast and Furious, this isn't a movie, it's tradition.